I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed unto this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Israelites, we have to take control of our minds. Whoever control the mind, control the body. If the kingdom of darkness have a greater influence on your mind, the kingdom of darkness is going to have dominance in your life. A carnal mind brings death.
For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace.
A spiritually minded person brings life and peace. Anyone who is led by the Holy Spirit will have a mind like the Most High, and peace will follow everywhere he or she goes. The Holy Spirit will be dominant in his or her life. The presence of the Most High will be everywhere he or she goes. If the Spirit of the Most High is active in leading, the kingdom of the Most High will have a greater influence in your life. The people who are Spirit-led will bear good fruits.
You shall know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes of thorns or figs of thistles? Even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. Every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. Wherefore, by their fruits ye shall know them.
Anyone who bear good fruit stems from the Most High. It is the Most High that does the work in us to transform us into the man and women he intended for us to be. A carnally minded person will operate in the flesh. The scriptures inform us that we could not please the Most High in the flesh.
Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then, they that are in the flesh cannot please God.
Many of our people do not understand what it means to operate in the flesh and in the spirit. Because many lack this knowledge, a lot of our people operate in the flesh. The flesh is the physical realm. Anything that gratifies the flesh, many people accept. To operate in the flesh is when a person lives by what they can see, touch, smell, and feel. For example, a man chooses a wife solely on her physical appearance. That is operating in the flesh. Another example, a person make life decisions based on what the mainstream media present. That is operating in the flesh. Operating in the flesh equals to anything that satisfies your body and emotions. Let's say I meet a woman who is feeling down and out because life is not going the way she thought. She is struggling and she expressed her circumstances to me. An example of response for me if I was operating in the flesh would be supporting her defeated mindset and joining her pity by complaining about my life. Operating in the flesh will make you ignore the behind-the-scenes events that are leading to our failures. The unclean spirits that are unseen behind the scenes are interfering with our lives. Our focus should be on the unseen. The things that are unseen are eternal.
For we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal.
In this generation, if you do not support a person's decision to engage in activities that are detrimental to them, you are considered a bully and evil. A good example I can give you is the Alphabet community. Anyone who is spirit-led and is of the Most High would not support nor compromise his or her belief to join another person's sins. The scriptures clearly state that we should not participate in another person's sins.
Lay hands suddenly on no man, neither be partaker of other men's sins. Keep thyself pure.
Many people have compromised themselves to accept and support the people of the Alphabet community due to fear. They are afraid of losing their jobs, sponsorships, and many other things they cherish. When the beast system is your source, you will accept every abomination the kingdom of darkness set before you. because most Israelites do not know how to fight against the alphabet community and the many attacks from the kingdom of darkness, they adopt the heathen's mindset and neglect the principles the Most High placed in them to serve him in the spirit and in truth.
This is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws into their hearts, and in their minds will I write them.
When you operate in the spirit, the world is going to hate you. The beast system is not going to accept you. The reason, you are a light to the world. When light hit darkness, the darkness disappear. You are an enemy to the kingdom of darkness. The kingdom of darkness operate in deceit. When you bring forth truth, it destroys the kingdom of darkness. The scriptures inform us that Satan is a liar and the father of it. There is no truth found in him. Therefore, his beast system would not accept you unless you are operating in the flesh.
Ye are of your father, the devil, and the lusts of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it.
Israelites, it should not be a surprise to you when they dislike you and shun you. The world hated Yahshua. The kingdom of darkness and the workers of iniquity had such a perpetual hatred for the Messiah that led to the heathens hanging him on a tree.
The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom ye slew and hanged on a tree. If the world hate you, ye know that it hated me before it hated you. If ye were of the world would love his own. But because ye are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hateth you.
The world do not know the Elohim of Israel. That is why they practice idolatry through religion. In addition, the world disregard the Most High's laws. Presently, the kingdom of darkness is using the corporations owned by the beast system to silence many. Operating in the spirit is looking beyond what is standing in front of you. Anything you wish to execute in the physical realm, you would have to consult with the Most High first before you proceed. The Most High is your only source when you walk in the spirit. Your job and businesses have no value to you. You must depend on the Most High for everything when you operate in the spirit. Operating in the spirit will allow you to speak truth even when the truth hurts. I will use the same example I gave you in the beginning of the woman complaining about her life failures. When the woman that is facing all kinds of trials seek a response from me, when I am operating in the spirit, I would have to ask her the tough questions. What sins are in her life that is giving the kingdom of darkness access? Instead of joining her pity party, inform her that the Most High can do exceedingly above and beyond what we could ever imagine.
Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us.
Some people find it harsh when you do not join them in complaining. Some get offended when you do not respond in the way they expect. These individuals or group want you to agree with their abominations and want you to tell them what they want to hear, even if they are wrong. As a person operating in the spirit, you have to tell them the truth, even if it hurts. In this present generation, we have Israelites doing what the scripture said they would do, turn to teachers that will participate in their sins.
But the time will come when they will not endure sounder doctrine, but after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables.
Do not expect to be loved, Israelites, when you are operating in the spirit. The scriptures say, woe to you when the beast system accept and praise you. They do the same with the false prophets and those who further the kingdom of darkness.
Woe unto you when all men shall speak well of you, for so did their fathers to the false prophets.
You have to be careful when the workers of iniquity and the beast system welcomes you. Your presence alone should and will convict those who operate in the flesh. It is important that you do not get offended when those who operate in the flesh get mad and begin to judge you and cast stones. That is what will happen when the words of the Most High cut them. The scriptures inform us the words of the Most High is powerful, sharper than any double-edged sword.
For the word of God is quick and powerful, and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart.
Most Israelites will shift blame instead of taking accountability when the words of the Most High convict them. Some Israelites do not bother to seek the Most High to find out why the words of the Most High cut them. They simply lash out, disregarding the consequences to their actions. Most of our people do not think about the cause and effect to their decisions. Once their feelings are hurt, attack mode is activated. Israelites, the scriptures clearly state, death and life is in the power of the tongue.
Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof.
It is important not to let the kingdom of darkness make you operate in negativity and emotions. Whenever your mind is bombarded with negativity and you are emotional, you are operating in the flesh. Emotions are unstable. When you begin to say ignorant remarks, those words will have an effect on the people who do not know how to defend themselves. Our forefather Jacob blessed and cursed his sons on his deathbed. He cursed his firstborn son, Reuben.
Reuben, thou art my firstborn, my might, and the beginning of my strength, the excellency of dignity, and the excellency of power. Unstable as water, thou shalt not excel, because thou wentest up to thy father's bed, then defilest thou it. He went up to my couch.
Some of our people believe judging and casting stones on a person has no effect. Reuben descendants were affected by the actions of their forefather's sin. Reuben slept with his father's concubine, which led Jacob to curse him. Reuben descendants were paying the price. When Moses noticed the curse upon the descendants of Reuben, Moses interfered, breaking the curse and said, "Let Reuben live.
Let Reuben live and not die, and let not his men be few."
Today, we have rebellious children. The next generation's action is the result of the sins of their parents. Many of our people are not prospering. Many Israelite homes are out of order. The head of the household placed the blame on their partner instead of the kingdom of darkness who is responsible. Some refuse to see it in that perspective because they are too focused on the flesh. We wrestle not against flesh and blood. When a corporation fails, the stockholders do not go to the employees to demand answers. A good leader knows how to train his employee to do their jobs well. The stockholders and partners to the corporation will hold the CEO accountable. The stockholders and partners will vote to fire the CEO and replace the CEO with the leader that is suitable to run the corporation. Any business that fails is the result of poor leadership. A business failing has nothing to do with the employees. Likewise, any household that fails is a reflection on the head of that household. The Most High will hold the head accountable, just as he held Adam accountable.
And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, "Where art thou?" And he said, "I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." And he said, "Who told thee that thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou shouldest not eat?"
Shifting blame did not stop the Most High from judging Adam. Saying to the Most High, "The woman you gave me made me eat," did not stop the wrath of the Most High against Adam.
And the man said, "The woman whom thou gavest to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat." And unto Adam he said, "Because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of thy wife, and hast eaten of the tree of which I commanded thee, saying, Thou shalt not eat of it, cursed is the ground for thy sake. In sorrow shalt thou eat of it all the days of thy life."
Many of our people need this reminder to take their ordained role seriously. Our children are cursed and wilding out because the parents are out of control. In addition, they are reckless with what they are saying. Our people thrive on roasting each other and saying mean and vile things towards each other. Many do not believe there are consequences to the words they let spew out of their mouths. Everyone has to give an account for every word spoken out of his or her mouth.
But I say unto you that every idle word that that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment.
If what you let come out of your mouth did not have consequences, the Most High would not hold you accountable for your words. You have to be careful with what you say. Too many Israelites in the awakening are playing with their lives when they allow anything and everything to come out of their mouth. The Most High would judge you harder because you should know better. Many Israelites who are awakened to their identity are still carnally minded. Some refuse to let the beast mindset go. Most bring the dysfunction and lawlessness into the awakening. That is why we have numerous doctrines of devils, division, and strife.
For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace.
Anyone who operate in the flesh, chaos follow them everywhere they go. Israelites, you have to allow the Most High to renew your minds. The awakening is not about boasting and judging other Israelites for their shortcomings, but repentance and humbling ourselves. In addition, taking the necessary steps to get our lives and community back in order. Crushing the spirit of a person is not going to make them change. It will increase the problems.
The spirit of a man will sustain his infirmity, but a wounded spirit who can bear?
It is important to take control of what you let entertain your mind. As a people, we have been subject to the heathen's beast system that program our mind to act a certain way. When the Most High awakened you out of your slumber, he delivered you from the demonic programming from the beast system. Now that you were awakened from your slumber, there is a great battle taking place within you. Your old self is still there. It is up to you to decide whom you're going to let influence your mind. The Most High did not awake you out of your slumber for no reason. The scriptures inform us to put away our old self and take on the new man by renewing your mind.
That ye put off concerning the former conversation the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lusts, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Wherefore, putting away lying, speak every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another. Be ye angry, and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil.
When our people start to understand how to operate in the spirit, they will begin to have control over their emotions. In addition, they will not be afraid to be bold and have the conversations no one wants to have. If you are awakened at such a time as this, there is a purpose. Do not let the kingdom of darkness steal from you the freedom the Most High has given to you. The scripture said the truth would make you free.
And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
We have to take advantage of the freedom and make it our duty to steer our people in the right direction. The scriptures instruct us to cast down every imagination that rise against the knowledge of the Most High and bring every thought into obedience of the Most High.
Casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
By replacing negative thoughts with the words of the Most High, this will help Israelites renew their minds and learn how to operate in the Spirit. When we begin to discipline ourselves and take our personal relationship with the Most High seriously, we will begin to see the changes. Everyone has to do his or her part. In order for the Most High to assist us, we have to take a step. We have to trust the Most High. Israelites, do not let the kingdom of darkness take you back into bondage. Do not let the beast system transform you into a self-righteous monster.
A fool hath no delight in understanding, but that his heart may discover itself. When the wicked cometh, then cometh also contempt, and with ignominy, reproach. The words of a man's mouth are as deep waters, and the wellspring of wisdom as a flowing brook. It is not good to accept the person of the wicked, to overthrow the righteous in judgment. A fool's lips enter into contention, and his mouth calleth for strokes. A fool's mouth is his destruction, and his lips are the snare of his soul.
Your beliefs should not correspond with the beliefs of this world. Israelites, do not be afraid to separate from the beast system. As you allow the Most High to renew your mind, No devil can pluck you out of the hands of the Most High. Do not let the agents and rebels among us change your views. Walking in the flesh corresponds with the program mindset inherited from the beast system. When you humble yourself and repent, the Most High is renewing your spirit and mind. Through this process, you will be able to hear the voice of the Most High. Your perspective of this world will change. You will begin to see the Most High in action. When you begin to operate in the spirit, everything that was hidden behind the scenes will begin to manifest before your eyes. You will gain a better understanding of our people's conditions. Walking in the spirit and letting the Most High renew your mind will give you the confidence needed to know there is hope for our people. We should collaborate with the Most High to clean up our households and our communities. A stable home creates a stable community. We need both the man and woman working together, submitted to the Most High to bring change. Israelites, it is time that you let the Most High renew your minds.
Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me, and know my thoughts, and see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting.